Hey, today we're going to take a fresh look at centering. We shot our video 3 or 4 years ago and it hasn't gotten any lighter. So today we're going to shed a little bit of light on centering. I'm going to center this piece of clay to throw a cylinder. I like to throw on a vat. I like to make sure my vat is clean and moist. And I like to, and you want to sit at the wheel at a height that feels comfortable for you. We're all different heights, so find a chair that feels right. And then I want to sit when I'm at the wheel with my elbows on my knees and my hands in the center. Again, it should feel comfortable. I'm going to put my ball of clay on with a bit of attitude. If you do miss the middle, it's not a big thing. You just push it to the middle. And I want to put my elbow on my left leg, at a place that it feels comfortable. Some people like to push it into the body or elbow. Wherever on your leg it feels right for you, that's where it feels, that's where it's right. If it doesn't feel right, it's not. Put a little bit of water on that. If you notice, my left hand is in the middle of the ball. My pressure is square in the middle. We're not to one third or two thirds. It's cutting the clay in half, and it pushes the clay up. Now my right hand is going to go across. Again, with the pressure directly in the middle, it's going to push the clay down. Again, my right arm is on my leg, wherever it feels comfortable. Again, if it doesn't feel right, it's not. So then I'm going to push it up, and my right hand's going to push it down. And it's a slow transfer of pressure. As your left hand pushes the clay up, your right hand is still applying pressure to keep it in control. And then you slowly transfer the pressure to down. And as your right hand pushes down, your left hand is still applying pressure to keep it in check. It's just less of to allow it to move and get some movement in your clay. If you do find a little thing, I like to get rid of those little messy things. And we're centered to throw a cylinder. But just keeping in mind with the pressure, cutting in half this way, pushing it up, and this way, pushing it down. The clay has nowhere else to go in the middle of both pressures in the middle. Notice my hands are joined when I can. And if you have your elbows on your knees and your hands joined, you have this sort of triangle of strength. And you want to make sure you get some movement in your clay. You have to push it hard enough to move the clay, but not push it right off the wheel. And also keep your clay quite moist. Don't worry about a lot of water at this point. When you're sitting down and first starting to pot, you have to worry about where your hands are, where your elbows are they joined, where your knees are, how fast should I go. And then the last thing that you need to control or worry about is water. It will come, I throw quite dry because I choose not to throw in the splash pan. I throw a lot of larger pieces and they simply just don't fit inside. So that's centered for a cylinder. Let's look at this again from another angle. I'm going to put the clay down with a bit of attitude. If it's not near the middle, you can tell it to go there. My arms are at a comfortable place on my knees. I'm a comfortable distance away from the wheel. And my pressure, my left hand, as you can see, is in the middle. I have the same amount of clay on this side as I do on that side, and I'm going to push it up with the heel of my left hand. Meaning this part right at the bottom of my, at the end of my bone. I'm just going to push it up. And then my right hand is going to push it down. Again, my pressure is in the middle of the clay. It's not off to one side or the other. And I'm using this fat thing underneath my little finger. And it's a slow transfer of pressure, pushing it up and pushing it down, pushing it up and pushing it down. And if both pressures are in the middle, the clay has nowhere else to go but center. When you're centering your clay, make sure you have enough moisture so your hands slide freely. I don't like to use a lot of moisture. Use whatever feels right. And make sure you get some motion up and down. And then it has nowhere else to go but center. You can see where I was working there and there, and it's centered. If you do get messy bits, you can get rid of them. So the secret to centering is centered pressure.